truth and life. Here is the Brother Leon Show. You better recognize.
What's going on, listeners? This is your boy, Brother Leon, and you are tuning into another episode of the Brother Leon Show today. Today, we are going to give props, and we are going to remember the man, Kevin Samuels, because he brought the thunder, the fire, the truth. We are going to honor him this day. The one thing that I want you guys to understand and know is that Kevin Samuels was an icon. He passed away on Friday. I'm not going to lie, man. I didn't want to believe it. But the one thing that is true is that there were a lot of people that loved him and there were a lot of people that hated him. Hated him to the point where they would even celebrate his death. This man was labeled a whole lot of things. There were things that people agreed with him about, and there were also things that people disagreed with him about. But the one thing that I am thankful for him is that he gave a voice to men. He gave a voice to a particular type of man. And the particular type of man I'm talking about are those nice guys. The ones who got labeled as simp, the ones who got labeled as just a regular dude or average guy. And the one thing that I love about Kevin Samuels is he was for the black community. And he brought out the issues that affected the black community as a whole. And the one thing that he did, he operated as a prophet. Because he lifted up his voice like a trumpet and he began to show the black community their sins, their iniquities, their brokenness. And a lot of people didn't like the fact that he came with facts. I think the one thing that amazed me about this man is his awareness. The fact that he listened and he could pick apart an argument. But the crazy thing about him is that his beginning was small. But he rose to fame just being honest. And the one thing that we as black people, a lot of times we don't like to hear is honesty. We don't like it when people call us on the carpet with our bullshit. We don't like it when people call us to accountability. And this is the one thing that he did. Because, you know, the whole term high value man, he coined that phrase. He also coined a whole lot of phrases. Like fit, friendly, and feminine. Three F's, if I'm saying it right. But the one thing that I will say is this, is that his message will live on. His message will live on, and I pray to God that there will be other men that will take up his standard, or even women. And there were women that supported his content and what he did, such as Crimson Cure, such as I Am Shalakemia. And so these sisters, I give you props. Thank you. Because we need black women like you. We need black women like you who are going to protect. We need black women like you who are going to be there. And so the one thing that I want you to understand and know is this, is that at the end of the day, Kevin Samuels was a gift to us. Because the one thing that I will say is that when it comes to nice guys, man, they always finish last. When it comes to simps, even though you perform, a lot of times you still don't get the outcome or the respect that you deserve as a man. And so he brought that to the forefront and he gave black men back their value. Because the only value seen through a woman's eyes or some women's eyes was the fact of how much does he make. And this whole thing, he challenged the whole notion of feminism in the black community. He challenged it. And a lot of women did not like what he said. He even challenged it when it came to the church. Because the one thing that I will say is that if you are in church, they will indoctrinate you to a certain degree to be a simp. They will use Ephesians 5 on you until you punch drunk. And so you have to realize how important his words were. And so today I just want to honor this man. I just want to be able to get to a place where we as people can understand who he was, what he was. I believe, man, that this death happened too soon. Because I was waiting for a Kevin Samuels book. I was actually waiting for a Kevin Samuels show, a live TV show, or even some type of special that was on one of these cable shows, something. But, you know, unfortunately, we'll never see that. But the one thing that I will say is that he created a platform and he created a matchmaking site where people had the outcomes that they wanted. People got married. And that's the one thing that he was pushing. And a lot of people didn't like the fact of his delivery. But the man spoke truth. And sometimes you need to be shaken to get out of that drunken stupor that a lot of times we're in when it comes to delusion. I'm serious. And so the one thing that I will tell you is this. And I'm just going to say it the way that it is. He healed a lot of men that were emasculated because of the words that he spoke. He gave certain men back their strength. He gave certain men back their value. And when you begin to talk on issues like that, they will try to shut you up. They will label you misogynist. They will call you all types of things other than a child of God. And that is what has happened to Kevin Samuels. They called him everything under the sun. But he still kept on going. This man, he built his platform to 1.4 million viewers and followers. And so the one thing that I want you to know is that he did that. He started off talking to men. He did that. And then he challenged men. But then his platform began to transition. And his platform exploded when he primarily started talking to women, because women wanted to know, how do I attract this type of man? And then he began to be honest and telling sisters like, yo, sister, you ain't gonna be able to get that type of man with what you dealing with right here. And a lot of people felt as though that, how is it that you can say that to me, because I deserve this, I deserve that. And he will call them on the carpet and say, you don't deserve shit. Nobody deserves anything. You get what you work for. And a lot of people did not like that, because there's so many people today feeling like they deserve this or they deserve that because the hardness that they went through in life, or because their father treated them like they were a Disney princess. I'm going to tell you this. It don't matter. You're only going to get what you are. You're only going to get what you work for. But a lot of women have been indoctrinated to think that they deserve this, that they deserve that, without responsibility, accountability, or even work. Men and women. And then he called a lot of single black women on the carpet when it came to emasculating their sons or making their sons surrogate husbands. He called them on the carpet with that. He also called men on the carpet about, yo, man, if you can't take care of yourself, ain't no need in you dating. Because you got to begin to take care of yourself. He called men on the carpet with that. And so there's a whole lot of things that we can say about Kevin Samuels. But the one thing that I will say is that, yo, he spoke truth. He pointed out some ratchet shit. I think probably the most ratchetest thing that he pointed out was an episode where there was a woman that called him up talking about, yo, I want to see if I can get me a high value man. But then she began to explain about the relationships that she had. She was married. This woman was. And the man that she married, she started to cheat on the man. And so the man found out and he started cheating. So her retaliation was to cheat on him again with somebody close and to have a baby by this person. Come to find out, the person was the man's cousin. So Kevin Samuels called her on the carpet and was like, out of all the dudes you could have picked, why this dude? And her excuse was, oh, I wanted to hurt him. And so now it's like, oh, because you wanted to hurt him, now you brought a child into the scene. And I mean, it couldn't get no messier than that. He called her on that. And then she tried to cover it up by, you know, sashaying her hair and all like that. And I mean, the one thing that I love about him is that he calls bullshit bullshit. And the phrase with him is, you can't make this stuff up. And that was probably the most ratchetest episode that I've ever seen. Then also the episode whereas it was a young black girl on there talking about, ooh, we don't need the black man because we educated, we got our own money, so why would we need him? And the crazy thing is that he's always brought attention to the black community. Because this is the narrative that is out here that is loud. That you don't need the black man. That black men won't protect you. So my question is, who is this coming from? Because it ain't coming from black men. It's coming from an angry black woman, or it's coming from a feminist that then hypnotized a black woman to say all that mess about the black community. Because now it's getting to the place, can we as black men say that the black woman wants us? Are they our women? That's the question that he posed. And so the one thing that I will say is this, is that in order for us to come together, if you want the outcome that you want, there are some people that you just gonna have to turn off. And that you're gonna have to reclaim your mind back. Because there's so many people, they get, oh, I don't like how he said it. But it was the truth. I'm going to tell you, the state of the black community and families is like a fucking burning house. I ain't got time to stroke your fucking feelings when the house is burning. I'm going to yell. I'm going to holler. I'm going to grab you. Because the house is burning and I don't want to see you die. Kevin Samuels was the alarm. You can have all these other dudes that can stroke your feelings and let your fucking ass burn. But the one thing that I will say about Kevin Samuels is this. He lived his message. He didn't say one thing and then was something else. He lived his message. And there was a whole lot of people that came against him. Church people came against him. And I'm like, y'all need to shut the fuck up. Seriously. Because at the end of the day, you see the disarray that the black family is in. And if you as a prophet or a pastor or apostle, whoever you want to call yourself, are not addressing the issues, then who will? You got to look at the majority of single black women with children in the church. Why is that? They believe in God for a husband. So my question is, why is it that we're not promoting anything in our churches that's going to get these girls married? That's going to deal with some of the issues that they are facing right now. And some of them need to wake the fuck up to reality. And say, yo, sis, because of your past, this is where you are. So you're going to have to make adjustments where you are. Not saying that God can't bless. But even if God don't give you a six-figure man, even if God don't give you a knight in shining armor, if God sends you a man who's going to be a husband to you and a father to your child, are you willing to accept that? But because of the drunkenness that is out here right now and the words and the witchcraft that is out here right now, a whole lot of women will turn down an average guy, even though he might be good. They'll friend zone his fucking ass and be waiting on a millionaire. And I'm going to tell you, man, yo, some of you might end up losing that because, number one, you don't look like Ciara. Number two, you don't look like Beyonce. You don't look like Kelly Rowland. You might think you are, but you ain't. And these are some of the realities and some of the things that Kevin Samuels brought to the table, and a lot of people didn't like that. He made men realize, yo, brothers, there's more that you bring to the table. And then you have to look at, what is the woman that's coming into your life bringing to the table? If all it is sex, it ain't that much. Because the one thing that you have to see is that if you're going to build together, if you want a certain type of man, you have to ask yourself, are you that certain type of woman? Would you be able to handle the stresses and the burdens that come with that man? And then on top of that, if you are that man, would it be fair to you to raise another man's child? So he called people on the carpet when it came to that. Why is it that you want a high value man, but you gave a lower, lesser man a child? And why do you expect this high value man to take care of a lesser value man's child? Why? Because you can sex him good? If you ain't on that man's level, and what I mean by level is you're in those type of rooms. And I mean in those type of rooms whereas you know you work them. You know the language. You ain't there as a guest, but you're there because of the work that you've done. If you ain't that type of woman, then you have to ask yourself, if this man is choosing to be with me, why is he choosing to be with me? Is it because of sex? Because there's a whole lot of options that this man has, just like you. So I'm telling you this day, man, Kevin Samuels woke us up to the fact that these type of men have options. And yeah, they might date you, they might want to smash. But at the end of the day, when it comes to marriage, that's a whole different bag. And so you can't get mad if this type of man, a high value man making six figures with no kids, decides that he wants to start a family fresh. You can't get mad at that. You can't get mad at a man that wants to start a fresh family if he's only making $56,000 a year. You can't get mad at that. Because the crazy thing is, we act like that men should settle, but women ain't got to settle. We act that men are supposed to do X, Y, Z, but we're very reluctant to say that women are supposed to be or do X, Y, Z. And if we do say that or be that, then we're labeled misogynistic. We're talked upon and put upon and say that it's toxic masculinity. It's the whole iniquity of patriarchy. But I'm going to tell you, man, men created this world, this system, and everything that women benefit from. And if men were to leave this planet today, I do not believe that women will be able to run it the way that men have ran it and are continuing to run it right now. Yeah, I said it. Because when you look at everything that was created. When you look at the thing about feminism, the fact is that they want the power of men, but they don't want the burden or the responsibility that comes with those men. When it comes to armies, who you think dies first or dies fastest? The men. When something happens, who do you think they say, oh, hey, women and children first? Men commit suicide. Men take jobs that are pretty much men-centered. Women ain't going to take certain jobs. Women ain't trying to be a bricklayer. Women ain't trying to clean sewer lines like I do working and shit. You very rarely will see a woman in that field or say, oh, I want to be in that field. Nah. It's because, number one, either ain't nothing out there that they choose that, or they ain't got the education to get something above that. That's the reason. A lot of times, some of these jobs ain't by choice. It's the fact that it's the only thing available that's going to give them a means. But that's the one thing that I love that Kevin Samuels brought. He brought truth. And so I want to play a clip, because you need to hear what he brought to us. Because he delivered and healed a lot of men. And I ain't gonna lie, I was one of them. I wish to God that I would have ran across Kevin Samuels early on in life. I'm serious. I wish that I was one of the dudes that was following him when he was talking to men. Because I probably would have made half the messed up choices that I made. And that's the God knows truth. Because, you know, to some he was a father, to some he was a brother, to some he was a friend. And one thing that he has said, he's like, yo, man, men have ran up on me saying thank you. Yo, man, can I get a picture? Can I get an autograph? And that is what we need. That is what we need, because there's so many men's voices that have been silenced when you start talking about men's issues, when you start talking about men's rights, fathers' rights. They will silence you. And that's the one thing that you got to understand. You got to understand what the nice guy is. You have to understand what a simp is. Because even though there may be some women that say they want a nice guy, sometimes they don't even give that nice guy the respect that is deserved. And the detriment of a nice guy is he has the tendency to pedestalize the woman that he loves. And he does it because it's so easy. Because it's indoctrinated into him. It's taught to him. It's taught to him at home. And it's also taught to him in his place of worship. So I want you to begin to listen, man, to what he has said.
Why men simp? Why? I'm going to talk about why I simped. I'm going to tell you exactly why men simp. And it goes into a point I'm about to make. You know, as soon as a man starts to speak his truth or be a man, society just wants to shut that stuff down. I want to shut it down. We can't have that, because men doing their thing, when a man has his mindset to do his thing, that man can't be controlled. So we got to shut that man down, separate him, isolate him, and keep him in line so we can keep the wheels of society on and get world production. That's really what it comes down to. So a super chat, somebody super chatted a question. This is a video for Sean G. He basically asked, Kev, can you go ahead and explain why guys continually simp for women and the dangers of simping? Okay. For people who don't know what simping is, it basically means being a fool for a woman. Being a fool for a woman. And putting her needs above yours to the detriment of yourself. Why guys do it? We do it because it's safe. We do it for a lot of reasons. But if you were born after 1970, you were raised in a world like I was, where Equal Rights Amendment, women were independent, all these other things. And a lot of people were raised by single parent households, and women, we were taught to be nice guys, be respectful of one, open the door, all those things. You know, guys before knew how to do that stuff. They didn't have to be taught. They just learned it from their fathers and the family and the society and culture. Well, women taught their sons how to be men. So obviously you got a generation of softer men and conversely a generation of harder women. Well, when you leave your mama's house and go to school, that's the first time a lot of guys were around boys. Then our boy tendencies started to pop up and manifest themselves, you know. So especially if you were like me, an only child, it was just me and my mom and around her sisters. Oh my God, it's a wonder I didn't turn out to be gay. And so I've heard a lot of people say that, but I don't, you know, that's a subject for a whole nother time. And you know, look, I'm conservative on some things, I'm liberal on some things, but I really, really do believe in men should be able to be men. We have all been programmed and taught that being a nice guy is the way to be. That's why we end up simping. Simping is a symptom of programming. So when I was telling the stories yesterday about how I would go from, you know, doing what a guy should do to being this nice guy and end up getting abused and mistreated by women, that was an internal conflict going on in me of me trying to basically fight against my programming. Another thing, though, is even after a guy knows better, we go back to simping because it's safe. We know how to simp. That's it.
Yo, I'm telling you, this is gold and priceless to a man, to a brother. I'm telling you right now. Yo, this video is called Stop Playing It Safe, Why Men Simp by Kevin Samuels. Go on his YouTube page and listen to the rest of it. Because I'm telling you, he gave a voice to us. He gave the antidote to us. And this is the reason why I honor him, because he gave men back their manhood. And he was very transparent with his life. And that's what I appreciate about him. He talks about his episodes in the church. He talks about his life in the church. He talks about some of the toxicity that is in the church. And some of the toxicity that is in our black families. And that's the one thing, man, that I will forever appreciate about Kevin Samuels. I do believe, and I could just be, you know, I'm just saying this. I think one of the things that led to his demise is the one thing that was always constant with him is those Red Bull energy drinks. So I do believe that might have been some of the cause of why he passed, because he was always popping a Red Bull. Now, I don't know what went into the preparation of his shows. I don't know what type of sleep patterns or anything that he had. And I'm not trying to start any type of controversy or conspiracy theory. But the one thing that I'm going to say is this, man. I still wish that he was here. I wish that this was all a dream, that this was all a lie. Because there's some people, man, on Facebook, Instagram, all over the place, especially Clubhouse, that rejoiced and still are rejoicing that he is gone from us. And so my question is, what type of person are you that you can rejoice in the death of a man that spoke his truth? You know, and I know some people might say, oh, he's toxic, he's abusive, he's this, he's that. No. No, not this man. This man was the uncle that you didn't want to hear speak his truth. But he told you the truth whether you liked it or not. But the amazing thing is that people tuned into his show night after night. Women kept calling in, even after the fact that some women called him misogynistic, a whole lot of labels, lies. They even said that he was gay. Whole lot of labels and lies. But the one thing that I will say is this, man. Look at the video or the interview that he did with Vlad TV on Vlad TV. Look at the interview that he did on Vlad TV. And also look at the interview that he had with Tasha K. Because the one thing that I'm going to tell you is this. You have to begin to look at our community. When even some of our black women that have said some of the things that Kevin Samuels has said, even some of them have gotten pushed back. April Mason has gotten pushed back by black women. Kendra G has gotten pushed back by black women. Shahrazar Ali has gotten pushed back from black women. Ayanna Van Zant has definitely got pushed back from black women. So you need to ask yourself, what is going on in our black households? Even our black women who come as healers are throwing up their hands and saying, yo, I'm done. I'm serious. Why is that? I think today, man, we cannot allow ourselves the luxury of brokenness. Because as long as we broken, brokenness will beget brokenness. And we have to ask ourselves, are we willing to heal? Because when something is broken, and a lot of times you have to re-break certain bones and then reset them so that it can heal the right way. And a lot of people can't take the breaking because they've gotten a lot of attention and they've been able to function in something that is out of order, out of joint, that didn't heal the right way. So I am here to tell you this day, I thank God for Kevin Samuels, for what he was as a man, for what he gave us as black men. And even what he's given to some black women who have accepted some of the things and come to the truth and the reality of how things are. I appreciate that. Because there were women who changed and got the outcome that they wanted. There were some women who actually, oh, I had a good man, and then they got that good man back. Because they got indoctrinated thinking that, oh, I can get something better than what I got. And then they realized the pickings is slim out here, and they went back to where their man was and made the relationship right. They had reconciliation and restoration. And that's what God wants for us. So yeah, I'm going to be one of the dudes that takes up the sword, that takes up the message, because it needs to be heard. I'm going to tell you, man, all black men are not toxic. But we have believed that because of the experience of certain black women and their individual experience, and now they want to label the whole collective. So I'm going to tell you this day, man, watch out. Watch out. But I thank God for the prophet and the gift that Kevin Samuels was to us.
And I regained my name, and I fought hard.
right, yo. Man, what a way to end. That was Black Men United. And I just want you guys to understand and know, man. Kevin Samuels, thank you. Thank you for everything that you were to us. Everything that you brought to us. The message that you gave, the gift that you are, the person, the man who you are. Thank you. And may you rest in peace. Peace.
Walk in the truth that makes you free every day. Follow Brother Leon on all social media outlets.